So just before we get stuck into this video, I just thought I'd show you what the world of scale modelling trains or HO trains or train sets gets up to these days. Gone are the days of analogue trains, which in the 70s and the 80s were the big thing. These days they do digital trains. So the same way that you relay information from your telephone to your or your mobile phone or smartphone to your computer is the same way that the commands for these digital trains are translated from the transformer or the computer hard drive system for them goes to the trains via the tracks through two wires, which is pretty unbelievable. So I'll crank this thing up. So you get sound, you get lights, and it makes 9 different sounds. This thing's pretty unbelievable. I'll just run you through the basic sounds. So that's at idle. This is what it sounds like when it goes. Hopefully it's going to work. Yes. Yeah, we'll put it in reverse. That's a little thing. That's awesome. Here it comes. We'll bring it back. How unbelievable is that, hey? Hang on. A little bell. That's awesome. Coupling and uncoupling sounds. Wild. That's crazy. And the big one. The horn. Yeah, the horn. Unbelievable. So there you go. If you're into the HO trains, they've come a very long way these days. Unbelievable stuff. Okay, so back to the task at hand. The kit review and build video of the Express locomotive BR01 and 02 Revell German locomotive. I'll give you a look inside this kit, and it's unusual that I should still have the other half of this kit so I can actually show you before I rip it apart and build the model, which is fantastic. What's inside and how great this model is in terms of the manufacture of the parts for it. Really, really clean, really fantastic looking model. So give you a quick look. So these are all the parts on the runners still. This is the BR02, which I haven't completed yet. The one you're about to see is BR01. This version is the 4-cylinder version of this locomotive, which wasn't mass-produced in the 20s. The BR01 is the 2-cylinder version, which was mass-produced. But as you can see on these sprues, just have a look at how clean and beautiful the parts are. Just absolutely magnificent. So kudos to Revell Germany for that. Magnificent, fantastic. The parts are also molded in colour. So there's no necessity for priming and mucking around. It's all ready to go, which is fantastic as well. This is a very fiddly little kit. There's lots of tiny little parts on it. So you can see here the couplers and so on. Very, very small parts, very fiddly work, but of course the result of having so many little tiny parts on this build is that you get a very finely detailed and beautiful model at the end of the ride. So that's fantastic. And here's the wheels and the sub parts of the chassis, the drive arms. Yeah, pretty awesome. As I say, like, there's just a lot of messing around with this model because it's so fiddly, because you've got to sort of get those little tiny parts on. It did take a long time to make this model. Just another thing while we're at it, these little parts are very difficult to paint, so I didn't resort to my usual venue for acquisition of paint brushes. I actually went to a place called Riot Art and Craft, so I don't go to my hobbyist for my paint brushes. This one cost me $3.50, and you can see how fine that tip is. It's unbelievable. so you can really get some extra fine detailing. So don't just resort to your hobbyist as a venue for picking up stuff. There's all sorts of places you can go to pick up tapes, brushes, glues, wire, all sorts of things that you need to bring life to your scale models. This is the equivalent of a 99 cent store. It's a $2 shop sort of affair. Have a look at that, $4.50 for 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 brushes. So that's less than $1 a brush, which is absolutely unbelievable. And have a look at the ends on those, just magnificent. I'm using another 6 at the moment and it's still lasting me. I've had them for about 9 months. So yeah, always check out everywhere for your parts and stuff. This is another thing I got from Bunnings. Rust-Oleum glitter. I'm not sure you can sort of see the glitter all that well, but it's really cool. So I'm thinking I'm going to do a matte black 49 Mercury and have glitter flames on it. It's going to be totally fantastic. So there you go. That's your kit review. Now I'm going to run the build photos. I'm Uncle Smifkins. This is Model Mayhem Mania, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Smifkins out.